Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Friday, December 10th, 2010. In the pre-market on Friday morning, we've got stock index futures slightly above fair value, so we are expecting a little buying at the open at 9:30 on Friday morning. Now, last time we spoke, we had just come off a bearish reversal day, and we were looking for a downside price movement to confirm that market top, and so far we really haven't seen that. Now, we still have the VIX on a sell signal that is supportive for higher stock prices. We need to close above 20.04 to give us a new buy signal for the VIX, which would be negative for stock prices. Look at the S&P 500 cash index. We need to close below $1,204.93 on Friday to give us a sell signal. Big up week for bank stocks this week. Took out the previous high, which is bullish. Things would not change for the bank index unless we started to close below 133.15. NASDAQ stocks have been treading water for the last week. We need to close below 2161 on Friday to give us a sell signal. The SOX index has been moving higher. We need to close below 401.55. Gold stocks have retreated this week, come into the channel, but have not closed below it. We need to close below 217.35 to give us a sell signal on Friday. Cloud computing stocks are still holding up very well. Cramer's Mobile Internet Index looks much like the NASDAQ itself, treading water. Credit card stocks have been up this week, but have not been able to take out the previous high. We need to close below 72.54 to give us a new sell signal and a new high for weight loss stocks this week. Taking a look at my five favorite stocks, we're still long Apple Computer. That would change with a close below 314.05. The CME's had a good week. We need to close below 301.25 to give us a new sell signal. Google is still on a buy signal, not really getting a lot of upward momentum here. The bottom of the open gap seems to be an issue. We need to close below 577.30 to give us a new sell signal. Goldman Sachs, we're looking for a close below 160.46. And for Visa, we're looking for a close below 75.84. And last up for stocks, for Research in Motion, we've come down to the bottom channel line 2 days in a row. We still need to close below $60.48 to give us a new sell signal on Friday. Take a look at the U.S. dollar. It is still on a sell signal, has come back to the upper channel line. We still need to close above 80.45 for the U.S. dollar index. The euro is still on a sell signal. Bonds had an inside day yesterday, still on a sell signal, of course. We need to close above 125.59 to change that. Taking a look at commodity ETFs, looking at copper, we need to close below 52.07 to give us a sell signal. For the GLD, a couple of weak days after that, looks like it's a double top, but we still need a sell signal to confirm that. We need to close below 134.87 to give us a sell signal on Friday. For the SLV, we're looking for a close below 27.42. For gasoline, we're looking for a close below 38.91. For natural gas, we're looking for a close below 591.90. And last up for commodity ETFs, we need to close below 36.86 for crude oil to give us a new sell signal on Friday. Just a couple of 60-minute charts this morning. S&P 500 cash index is in a little box up here. We had that low this week down at 1220, and so we'll be looking to see if that low holds. Really, we're bullish as long as we stay above 1214. So any pullback back to 1214 keeps us bullish. On the VIX, we can remain bullish as long as the VIX stays below the flypaper channel. If it starts raising back up above it, then of course we're bearish once again. And we know if we're up over $20, we're going to get a buy signal on the daily chart, and that would be negative for the market overall and would be reflected in not only the hourly charts, but the daily charts. Okay, that's all for Friday morning, folks. Not expecting a lot to happen today. Have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again on Monday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.